So here we've got our inverse Fourier transform. The central idea is to create the symbols with the inverse Fourier transform, and the input are different xk, so frequency coefficients or frequency samples. And these frequency samples usually encode with QAM. So every of them separately. And obviously here input is our data. And so this we are sending out to our bandpass modulator. And this is running twice the sampling rate fs. And then the output is a real valued sequence. So that's here complex. And this real valued sequence we can transmit, of course. So then on the receiver side, it's obviously we just do the same here what we always do. We do a bandpass demodulation like that, and then we're doing a Fourier transform, so FFT, and then this is just doing exactly the opposite here. And so then we just need to do a QAM decoding. So these are essentially thresholds, as we know. And then with that, we're getting out our data. So the question is, why is this not sufficient? So however, there's a problem with this. The problem is, we need to, in order that this FFT, this Fourier transform works here, we need to know exactly the start of the symbol, otherwise this is here completely messed up. So we need to know the start of the symbol. And the and it's not so easy. Remember that that our symbol, if this is here T and this is N, that our real symbol which we're transmitting there looks like that. And this is here T. Let's draw this T on top because getting out of the frame here. So that's our T. And so it's very hard to find out where this starts, because obviously it also continues here on the other side. And so to find that start here, find the symbol start.